This is Takeda Senko, a kimono dyeing factory run by the Takeda family. Kazuya Takeda has been dyeing kimono for 22 years, like his father and his grandfather before him. Today he's dyeing four traditional kimono, which start out as these pattern rolls of fabric.
This is the染めの D-Ren という作業を
Takeda-san doesn't make kimono and then sell them in a shop. He dyes custom ordered kimono, which means he has to create the exact color that his customer is looking for. Because those dye colors aren't pre-manufactured, he mixes the chemicals for them himself. The dyeing process will take several hours. The first step is perhaps the most challenging, creating the correct colored dye. Getting the color exactly right requires years of expertise and an artist's intuition. Now that the kimono fabric has been prepared, he transfers it to his dyeing machines. There are two types of machines he uses to dye the kimono, and he'll be using both types today. This machine cycles the kimono fabric through a basin filled with dye. Takeda-san makes sure that the kimono stays centered on the wheel by pinning metal rods to the fabric. He adds the dyeing chemicals to the front of the basin, which will slowly work into the fabric during the next few hours. This method is called hitashi-zome, which means boiling dye method. With this machine, the kimono hangs down into a dyeing pot and spins under the water. This too will take several hours, but unlike with the other machines, you can see changes immediately with this method. The results are stunning. While he waits for the dye to sink in, Takeda-san is constantly checking progress on all the kimono and making adjustments to the colors if necessary. When the kimonos start getting close to the correct color, he dries a spot of fabric on them and compares it to the sample his customer requested. Sometimes, the dye requires a bit of altering. When the dyeing process is finished, he transfers them to another basin that will set the dye and remove any excess chemicals.
どう？僕には違いが分かりません。だいぶ綺麗だと思うんですけど、まだまだですか？
いや、OK ということで。
OK。
もうちょっと遊んでね。あ、気持ちだね。
もう少し。
で、上つりつり余分なやつをこう洗い流してね、水で。
After the soaking process, he runs the kimono through a machine to squeeze out the excess water. And finally, he hangs up the kimono to finish drying overnight. After this, they'll be sent to another shokunin to be sewn together into the finished kimono. This is a book of Japanese family crests, which are called kamon. Many families have had their crests passed down through them for generations, but for families who have lost their crest or don't have one, Takeda-san says it's perfectly normal to select or create your own. These crests are used in the type of kimono dyeing that his family is known for, kuromonsuki. Kuromonsuki is a type of formal black kimono with family crests located on the chest and back. The Takeda family uses a method of dyeing the crest that's unique to Nagoya, called Nagoya Kuromonsuki. In this method, they sandwich cutouts of the family crest with wire mesh, which they then sew to the kimono. This allows them to dye around the cutout. The final details are then painted onto the kimono, resulting in the crisp design you see here.
前に2つと胸に2つと後ろに3つあるんです。うん、門は。で、5つ門が正式。あと略式で3つ、後ろに3つ。あるいは、まあ、背に1つ。1つ門、3つ門、5つ門と。一応3つありますけど、5つが一番正式ですね。着物と羽織に、男は。中が着物。で、上から羽織、これを着て、これが羽織ひもっていう、あの羽織を結ぶひもですね、これが。
黒い着物はいつ着るんですか？
男性の場合はお葬式に着てってもいいですし、結婚式に着てってもいいですし、本当にあのおめでたい席に、どんな表彰式でもこれ着てけば大丈夫です。女性の場合は、その喪服、これはお葬式の時ですね。あとさっき言った黒留め袖とかは結婚式とか、うん、これを仕立てるとこんなようになるんですよ。
それ琵琶ですか？
そうですね、琵琶が入ってるんですね。これを一遍全部ほどくとまたこの形に戻るんです。ほどいてつなげるとね、着物は、うん、だから染め替えもできますし、いろんなまたリサイクルが、リサイクルというかな、うん、まあ、昔のあの洋服みたいにね、曲線に切ってないので、全部直線に切ってるのが着物の特徴ですね。うん、着物っていうのは縫い目を見せないんです、外に。こうやって縫い目を見せないように仕立てるという日本の技術ですね、これ。うん、まあ本当にうちはこう、ずっと、まあ、何代も着ていただけるような染めということを心がけてね、うん、やってます。確かにそう、黒を見せるだけでしたら、染めた後に今いろんな薬品があるんでね、うん、より黒く見せるっていうのもあるんで、うん、やっぱりそういう上からやかけるとどうしてもあとあとね、いろんなあのそれが剥げたとこが白く見えたり、うん、しますので、そういうのは使わずにずっとまあ長年着ていただける。どんどんどんどん黒が良くなってくるようなね、そういうような、うん、それが祖父の今黒紋付きであるんですよ、うちに80年ぐらい前染めたやつが。それは本当にね、未だに苦労してますし、そういうのがね、できればなと思ってますね。
着物を着たい外国人についてどう思いますか？う
ん、ああ、素晴らしい。
あ、よかったです、はい、
ぜひぜひいっぱい着てくださいって感じですね、うん。で、外国の方もそうやって着物にお好きになっていっぱい広めている方もいらっしゃいますしね、うん、どんどん着てください、本当にね。
ありがとうございます、
うん、よかったらね。
本当にありがとうございました。
どういたしまして、ありがとうございました。
この仕事で一番こう楽しい瞬間って何ですか？
楽しい瞬間、
はい、
まあ、お客さんに喜んでもらえた時が、まあ、一番なんだけど、自分の中ではやっぱこうやって色々間違ったなっていうふうに思うことが、いいね、
そうですね、
俺って天才だぜっていうふうに、